Hey everybody. So we're back again with episode 4. And today we're going to talk about how to price your services and your packages, which is a huge, huge topic. A question that everyone has. And then so I'm going to go through it a little bit about how I do that and how you can do it, like some tips and tricks. So we'll go over if you charge hourly, if you have packages, just different ways that you can price your services. Since I know a lot of people have this question. So today we'll talk about how to price your services and how to price your packages. And just let me know if that's the step that you're on or what kind of step that you're, where you're at in building your business. And then, of course, leave your questions below. You can add more questions to this thread because I'll be doing this daily, like, show where we're gonna answer questions that you have regarding just business, even regarding how I kind of make time for business and personal life. Just any kind of questions you have for me, leave them, and I'll be sure to answer them. The first step to, as far as how you will price your services is figure out if you want to offer hourly rates or, if you just want to offer packages. Now, I still, even if I don't, since I really rarely, I don't even think I ever use like just hourly rate. I still calculate what my hourly rate will be because that still determines how much my packages will be. So I will, when I speak with a client and tell them what they need, I will kind of like brainstorm or estimate how many hours I think it'll take me to do that, and then that's when I will offer a package. Or like most of my clients, they will pick one of my smaller packages just to see how much I can get done during that time, and then they can move up if they need more hours, different things like that. So what I definitely do is figure out my hourly rate. Now, virtual assistants rates can vary from $20 an hour to over $50 an hour. So anything in between there, you can still book clients and, you know, have a successful business. I started off at the lower range just so I can gain clients quicker and then gain the experience too, as far as like online business, working with a business that is strictly online. I have a lot of admin experience, so I knew I could do that, but I wanted to get comfortable with doing everything virtually. So I started with a long range, and then I increased my rates, and I changed my packages as I seen fit. Like, I will figure out, when I work with different clients, I'll say, okay, I like doing this, but I don't like doing that. So I took it out my services. I added more services in. And so for the first thing is create, you know, figure out what your hourly rate will be. Figure out how many hours you want to work per week. Some people may have a 9-to-5 and they have part-time hours that they'll want to have for their business. So figure out how many hours you want per week and then figure out what your hourly rate will be. And so I use that hourly rate, which I have a worksheet that you guys probably have or you can grab, that you'll use your hourly rate to figure out your packages. But let's go back to how I figure out my hourly rate is I will figure out what I want to make monthly. What would be my monthly goal? So I would say $5,000 is how much I want to make monthly. And then I'll figure out how many hours did I want to work? Did I want to work full-time? Did I want to work part-time? So I'll say, okay, for me personally, I only want to work part-time. So I would say 20 hours. I will divide the monthly by 4 for the weekly. And then I would divide the whatever is by the weekly by how many hours I'll work weekly, which will give me my hourly rate. So then I would use that hourly rate to figure out my packages for 10 hours, 20 hours, 15 hours, 25, 30, whatever I'm offering to get the different packages that I have, how much they'll be. And then I also have on the worksheet where you can make niche-based packages. So let's say you have a blogger who needs like blogging management. Okay, you will say that you'll work on blogging, editing the blogs, making the graphics, posting them on their website, making sure that SEO good, which is like tags and keywords and different things like that. So that's a whole package that you'll offer to a blogger, because they will need all of that. And you will say, okay, I will have focused on this for this many amount of hours for you, and this is how much it will be. So you'll still need to know about how much you'll charge hourly, because you'll need to know how much you'll charge for that amount of hours for doing that job. So those are the kind of ways that I break it down, and I go through that on that worksheet. To kind of give you an idea of how to start creating your packages and creating your hours. Now, for me, two is I seen where maybe I was undercharging someone. But I think that what you do is when you get out there, once you start talking to people, once you start working with people, you will figure out a lot of this stuff. A lot of people change a lot of different stuff after their first client, because their first client is just something to get their feet wet, figure out things. So as you get clients, as you do different services for different clients, you can increase your rates, you will gain more services, you'll gain more experience, you'll work on different tasks, you'll learn from that client. So everything will change. But just set up your packages, your hourly rate to get in, to start, just to grab that first client. And you can keep the same rates. You can increase with that client, or you can keep that client at the same rate and increase with your next client before you sign them. So it's all based on trial and error. It's all about growing, learning, experiencing. And then I think that's the best way to kind of figure out how much you were charged. Of course, you can look at other virtual assistants to see if they do similar things to you and see how much you can charge that way. But ultimately, the decision is yours. It's your business. You can pick whatever hourly rate you want to pick and just go out there and start marketing. If you want to start with... everything is really on trial and error. I can't say that enough. All of this is going to be about you going out there and experiencing it firsthand, and then that's when you'll figure out what's the good price point, what's the good services, what's the good marketing tactic for you. So I think that's be the best way to price your services. Go ahead and figure out your monthly goal, break that down into your hourly rate, figure out your packages by using that hourly rate, and then have you a couple of niche-based packages if you choose to offer to a different kind of entrepreneur. So if we don't have any questions, I'll see you guys tomorrow on, that'll lead us into how do I market my business. So we'll discuss that on tomorrow. So, I will see you guys tomorrow, and I'll see you in a group. If you have any kind of questions, leave me a message or send me an email.